Hi, welcome back to my channel. I'm Farah, and in today's video, we're gonna talk about NoSQL injection attacks. Before we get into this video, let me tell you about today's sponsor, Snyk. Snyk is a tool which is used for finding and fixing vulnerabilities in your code, open source dependencies, and containers. It's a completely free tool, so you can use my link below to sign up on Snyk and start scanning your GitHub repositories, open source dependencies, Docker containers, and a lot more. And if you're interested in knowing about NoSQL injection attacks, then please continue watching. So what is NoSQL? NoSQL stands for Not Only SQL, and it's used to describe databases that rarely use SQL to manage their data. Instead of using columns and tables like a traditional SQL database, NoSQL databases implement other types of data stores like a key value store, a document store, a graph store, and this can be changed depending upon the application's needs and requirements. And because of this flexibility, NoSQL is gaining a lot of popularity, and usage of NoSQL opens up a whole new attack surface, especially for injection attacks. In traditional SQL injection, an attacker would inject a SQL query through user input, which the application would then pass directly to the backend database without any input sanitization. However, in NoSQL databases, there is no common query language like SQL, and the syntax of the query depends upon the implementation of the database. For example, a login query in SQL would be a simple select query like this. However, the same login query in MongoDB, which is a NoSQL database, would be constructed in JSON, and it would look something like this. In this video, we are going to exploit NoSQL injection on a MongoDB database. MongoDB is currently the most popular NoSQL database. It is a document-oriented database, which means that it does not use columns and tables. It also uses JSON to query the database and not SQL. Even though MongoDB does not use SQL to query the database, it still makes use of queries that are based on user input. And similar to how SQL injection works, if this user input is not sanitized efficiently, then it can lead to a NoSQL injection. So I'm going to use a lab to demonstrate this bug. This lab was cloned by me from Snyk's GitHub repository. And if you want to practice and reproduce this bug for yourself, then I'm going to leave the link in the description so you can check it out. Okay, so this is our lab right here. And as you can see, this is an admin login panel. I also have burp switched on, so I'm going to intercept the request. So first I'm going to enter the admin's username. Now I'm going to add a password. I'm going to add something random because I don't know the password. And as you can see, a post request is being sent to the login endpoint. And we have three parameters over here. We have username, password, and we have redirect page, which is empty. So let's send this to repeater so we can analyze the response as well. So since the password was wrong, we have got a 401 unauthorized error. Another thing that I want to mention is that I have switched on logging for MongoDB's query, so I can analyze the query that's going in the backend. Everything you see after Mongoose is the MongoDB query. So here we have users.find, and the data that we provided in the request is going as a JSON object. Once we exploit NoSQL injection on the login endpoint, we should be able to bypass authentication. But before we start creating payloads, let's look at the code of the application to understand where the bug is actually taking place. Okay, so this is the code of the application, and this right here is the login function. This indicates that the login function can access the login request and response. The next callback allows the login function to either log the user in or throw an error depending on whether authentication was successful or not. Now next, this checks if the username entered by the user is a valid email address or not. User.find, as we saw in the logs, is the main query which is used to look up the user's details. Here we take the username and password values that the user had entered and we directly pass them into the function, which contains the check for authentication. This line here checks if the username and password combination exists in the database. If it does, then the app authenticates the user to a valid session and redirects them inside the app. But if the username or password entered is wrong, then the app will return a 401 unauthorized error to the user. The app will also return this error if the user had entered an invalid email address. Now, the logic of the code is pretty simple, but as you can see, any value that the user enters in the username and password fields will directly be taken from the request body and passed on to the backend database for validation. Now, if the user enters a normal pair of credentials, there's not going to be any problem. But if the user enters a JSON operation, then that will also be passed on to MongoDB. And since MongoDB uses JSON to query the database, this can lead to a NoSQL injection and possibly an authentication bypass. Okay, so since we're going to be working with JSON in this request, I'm going to change the content type to JSON. I have a burp extension called content type converter which will do that for me. So as you can see now, the request body has been converted into JSON data. Now I'm going to enter a payload into the password field, and this is going to be a JSON operation called GT, which stands for greater than, and I'm going to explain the logic of this once I'm done typing it out. Okay, so basically here we are telling MongoDB to match this username with a password which has a value that is greater than an empty string. And since the password for this username obviously contains more characters than an empty string, this query will definitely discover a match for it in the database. So let's send it and see what happens. So as you can see here, we have bypassed authentication and we are being redirected to the admin endpoint. We can also check the logs to see what the query looked like. So after mongoose, here we have our query users.find, and the data that was passed in the request is being passed as a JSON query, and our operation here is being evaluated by JSON and passed on to MongoDB. And this is how we bypass authentication. As you can see, we are successfully logged in as admin at snake.io. So now that we know what NoSQL injection looks like, let's see how we can fix the bug using Snyk. Okay, so here I'm on my Snyk dashboard and I'm going to click on add projects. And I'm going to select GitHub because my code is on a GitHub repository. So I'm going to select the one that I want, and the vulnerable application I'm using is called Goof. So I'm going to click on import and scan. Now all I need to do is wait for my scan to complete, and then I need to click on code analysis to view the scan results. As you can see, this is just tested a few seconds ago. So here you can see that there are quite a few bugs that have been found in the code of all kind of severities. You can also filter them through priority, status and language. The one that we are interested in is SQL injection. So we can view full details, and here we can see that the exact code where the bug is found is highlighted, and we also have a brief description about the unsanitized input which flows into find and how that results in a SQL injection. Now if we go to fix analysis, there are also some suggestions for developers on how you can fix it or the best practices that you can use to prevent this bug. And this is what you can do for the rest of the bugs as well. And that's all I had for you in this video. If you found this helpful, then like it and subscribe to my channel. And thank you so much for watching. Bye.